Tuberculosis is estimated to kill 30 people in Uganda per day. The executive director of Uganda Stop TB Partnership, Dr. Paul Isiku Kawanguzi, has cited lack of knowledge on TB preventive measures as one of the escalating factors for tuberculosis transmission in the country.
Everybody should know that TB is among the infections, is the highest infectious killer in Uganda and in the world for the last few years. So it's actually killing more people than HIV. Actually, even among the HIV people, it's tuberculosis that kills more of the HIV people. So once, that's why we are always calling on everybody that if you have HIV, go and be tested for TB.
TB is a disease that is spread through air. When a TB patient coughs, when a TB patient laughs, sneezes, they release germs into the air. And these germs can actually be inhaled by another person in the vicinity. So if one wants to prevent TB, one way is to ensure that whoever has TB is treated very well, so they stop giving out those germs into the air.
Speaking at the workshop organized to sensitize journalists on TB in Entebbe, Dr. Kawanguzi rallied all stakeholders to join the TB campaign in order to achieve a TB-free Uganda by 2030.
Calling upon everybody, because we are determined to make sure that we end tuberculosis by 2030. And we cannot do it alone as health workers. We need everybody on board. And you, the journalists, and of course the community, let's make sure that we spread the information, knowledge. Once people are knowledgeable about tuberculosis, then we shall be able to end it.
The Ministry of Health is concerned that many TB patients are not completing their doses, which makes their bodies disease resistant, despite the fact that TB treatment is offered at zero cost.
Medicines for tuberculosis are free and available at all our health facilities, the public health facilities, and some of the private facilities that have been accredited by government. And we receive these drugs, they are regular, and we really, they're always there. But then we are having patients who have tuberculosis that we are missing in the communities.
We need to have the communities engaged, because these people actually do stay in the communities. They need to be knowledgeable. If one is coughing for 2 weeks or more, if one has failed in the case of children, to grow very well, chances may be TB. So communities need to be educated.
Uganda Stop TB Partnership now wants TB diagnostic services to receive the same attention as COVID-19 by incorporating it on COVID-19 testing, because the two have similar infections and symptoms. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news in Entebbe.
Serious sweating, then you know this might be TB.